Hey, what's up, y'all? Y'all know my slogan. I don't know it all, but I know what I've been through. Now, it's unfortunate to report this news today, y'all. It just seems like this year, man, can't get any worse, as I am unfortunate to report that your boy Slim 400, straight out of West Coast, man, has died of a fatal gunshot wound in California in the early morning of December 9th. And he was only 33, man. It's unfortunate because these rappers are losing their lives at an alarming rate. Man, every time you turn around, some type of rapper is losing his life to senseless violence. And it's like every time you turn around, man. So, I don't know, man. It seemed like it's a dangerous job being a rapper. I remember being a rapper was like the top thing to be, man. These days, it seems like that fame and all that money is starting to come with a price. But anyway, we're going to get into this article from the New York Post detailing the situation. And before we get into all that, make sure you like, comment, share, and subscribe. Hit that bell so you're notified every time we drop new content. And I swear it's lit here. So join one of the latest gangs on YouTube so you can stay updated with some of the realest content. Now let's get straight into it. Now it says here, Slim 400, a rising star on the West Coast hip-hop scene, has died of a fatal gunshot wound in California. He was 33. The Compton-raised rapper was gunned down Wednesday night in the Inglewood neighborhood of Los Angeles, law enforcement sources confirmed to TMZ. Now, no details about what ignited the deadly encounter or how many suspects were involved have been released at this time. Now, I don't know if y'all remember, right? But he pretty much escaped death before, right? When he was ambushed and shot 9 times while visiting his family in Compton in the summer of 2019. Alright, and if y'all remember in the Vlad interview he did, he said that one of his family members risked their own life to save him by dragging him indoors to safety amid a hail of drive-by bullets. And when they asked him about the situation, he said this, quote, "I just feel like when you're meant to be here and God have a plan for you, it ain't no stopping it." Alright, so he also said during that situation, when he was at an LA radio station, he said, quote, "I hit the ground thinking it was over. My family came out, kept me alive, talking to me, dragging me in the house while they still shooting. My family loved her to death for just saving me. I just feel like I'm blessed just to be here because I could have just died then and there, man." So, like I said, it's an unfortunate situation. And what's even unfortunate about it is his last story post, man. He pretty much said RIP to Young Dolph because one of his fans actually put up a song that they was listening to by him and Young Dolph called Shake Back. And he pretty much put rest in peace, Young Dolph. And now it's pretty much rest in peace for him, man. So it's an unfortunate situation. My condolences go out to his family, man. The senseless violence got to stop. Shout out to Slim 400, man. May he rest in peace. Y'all let me know how y'all feel about this in the comments. Don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Hit that bell so you're notified every time we drop new content. And remember, as long as you keep on watching, I'm going to keep on dropping. And I'm out.